Evening, ladies and gentlemen, coming to you live from the outskirts of the internet, this is the Gaming Saloon E3 Special Day 2, which on June 10th, 2014, with your host, Peacemaker2448.
Really, you're gonna stop?
What?
Normally, you go ahead and say everyone's names.
Oh.
Anyhow, and Ram.
I'm distracted, damn it.
Yes, yes, he is.
God damn it, I'm distracted. That's the problem, as I'm distracted. I need to close it so I can not be distracted anymore. Yes, folks, the Smash Invitational is still going on. They're at the celebrity match, and I'm just like, they had it in the background while I was doing the intro, and that's why I screwed up twice. So yes, folks, I'm being a bit dumb today.
Oh, God.
It's closed now, I swear, so.
You hope.
Yes. I'm not gonna lie, Smash looks really good. Like, really good.
Yeah. And I'll guarantee to you, there'll be people saying that, oh, it looks like every other Smash Brothers, and in a sense, yeah, but that's exactly what it is.
Yeah.
It is Smash. I mean, I don't see when people make complaints about games that's just blatant like that, it's like, okay, what did you expect out of it?
Yeah, we got 31 characters. Spoilers.
Wow.
Yeah, because just as a quick spoiler, we got 2 characters confirmed at E3 today. And Nintendo's still going to make announcements tomorrow. And who knows, they might announce another character at the end of this tournament. Just to be like, the tournament's over, here's a new character. Bringing our total count to 32. And trust me when I say this, when we get to that first new introduction, it's going to just about double the roster when you think about the mechanics.
Really?
Yes. Well, in a mechanical sense, it's going to double it. Design stance, it takes the roster and puts it up there into infinity, I believe.
Hmm.
But first, let's talk Sony. And by talk Sony, I mean talk that press conference we did not watch last night.
Yes, because we were streaming.
Yes. I have not watched the conference in its entirety. I have only watched certain things from it that look interesting. I might watch it in its entirety tomorrow. But yeah.
Thank you, Mivjo, for following us.
Thank you. But yeah. But yeah, I'm glad I found this article because this is literally everything that happened, apparently.
And Apocalyptic 87.
Holy.
Didn't even see that one hop into the chat. I was okay. I was expecting
thank
one,
you people
not
for follows.
The second, but thanks a lot for that.
Yeah, thank you. This is like the most consistent we've gotten follows. Granted, this is one of the more consistent times we've streamed, but I love that we have that now, so we can know when people follow the stream.
Exactly, and we can give people the thanks they deserve.
Oh, we were having fun before we started streaming because we were watching the Smash Invitational. And that Smash Brothers. I want. But yeah, Sony. Oh, all the things Sony has done. Because just scroll through the page. Just scroll through and look how much we have to talk about. This is.
Oh, jeez.
Apparently, they were going like just ridiculously long, and we have a lot of things to talk about from. So,
well, we do realize that Glock was watching through most of our show.
Yeah, and we went
yesterday, and we went a little over 3 hours, and the Sony press conference lasted like most of that 3 hours.
So we're looking at probably what, 2.5?
I know at least 2, because at 11 he said it was still going on.
Yeah, so probably like 2.5, but yeah. Oh, all right, folks. First up, I have too many things open.
Yeah, it's a darn wonder I'm not lagging right now.
Because my flash literally just crashed on me. I'm going to close some things. Because I got far too many videos open. I think this one article is going to be enough for now. But yeah. First up, we got new Killzone Shadowfall DLC. Killzone Shadowfall Intercept. Online cooperative expansion. Up to four players are placed on elite VSA team operating behind enemy lines on a mission to intercept and relay Hellgas military transmissions. We'll take a look at that.
You know why you said it wrong?
Why?
Because you still want Smash Brothers.
Yes. Yes. That's what's going to happen. Every time I make a flub, it's Smash Brothers' fault. That's exactly what it is. I ain't dissing on the game. I'm just saying.
Oh, God. We better not do that.
Why?
That puts me in too much of a mindset of a decade.
Oh.
Yeah, we better not do that.
Yep, alright.
As soon as that sentence came out of your mouth, I was like, oh, no, no.
You ready?
Uh-huh.
Alright, taking a look at the Shadowfall DLC in 3, 2, 1, go.
Alright guys, been waiting on this all day. Who's playing medic?
I was the medic last time. I'm gonna be the tactician.
I'll be the medic, guys.
Yeah, well, hang back. Don't be an idiot.
But I've never been an idiot. I've got your back. Okay, we're spawning. Let's set up.
Placing turrets over at A.
Is this just me, or is that a trend this year at E3?
The whole group conversation.
Yeah.
Yeah, but...
Yeah, I swear this is like about the, third, fourth time we've had that or something.
Yeah. I'm on my way, but I need help.
I'll place a shield.
I'm reviving you.
Guys, we're losing some points. Let's get on it.
I'll go bank for us.
I'll cover you.
Boom, shakalaka.
Go bank, get us some jetpacks too.
Crap, watch out, teleporting snipers. There's a supply box near the wall.
Turrets are down.
Capacitor spawned. Who's getting it?
Busy. I'm on my way. Got it. Coming home.
I'll cover you.
Looks good.
They're all over you.
Jetpacks it is.
Just received a jetpack.
Woohoo!
Oh, yeah!
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 Yeah. That'd be a fun co-op. I think that's a class beast. Wait a minute. That was a dial-up noise. What? Okay, it may just be me, but hearing a dial-up noise makes me go, wait, what? Mm-hmm. Why were you using dial-up noises?
Fax machines. Gotta love them.
Okay, do you see a, screen? One of the related videos has something related to Kingdom Hearts?
Think so.
I don't believe that is... Oh, I was about to say. That can't be real. Oh, it's a parody. Apparently it was a Frozen World confirmed, but no, it's a parody.
Yeah.
Thank you. I was about to say. Oh. And that got confirmed before the show, but... Hey. Shadowfall DLC looks cool.
Yeah.
For the actual presentation, we get Destiny first up with a brand new trailer. I don't know if they doubt anything to be in there that we haven't already seen from Destiny.
True. Watch him play about the first 30 seconds and then be like, oh, nope, there is.
No, I was kind of skimming through it. It looks a little bit story-esque, but we'll skip over it. More importantly, though, they announced that the Destiny beta is coming to the PlayStation 4 next month. Like, literally next month. July 17th.
But are they also going to do one for the other consoles, or is it just going to be a PS4 beta?
Possibly coming first on PlayStation 4.
Stands to reason. I think Bungie shifted more Sony side once they left Microsoft.
Mm, yeah. Oh, did you hear about the whole thing with Marty O'Donnell and Bungie?
Yep.
I don't know what the hell happened there. Smarties have been
either, because. Jeez.
Yeah, because Marty's been with them since, like, the beginning.
Yeah. Oh, he's the one that did the original score for Combat Evolved.
Yeah. Like, his music's still a part of Halo to this day. Mm-hmm. Even though Bungie's moved on. But yeah, that sucks. But anyway, this is where I was getting that alpha information last night. Starting this Tuesday, June 12th, PlayStation 4 folks will be able to play the Destiny First Look alpha as well.
Oh, so it was a combo.
Yeah.
The main topic was the beta coming next month, and then the subtopic was the alpha.
Yeah.
Which is why, which warranted the tweet.
Yep, and we're also getting a Destiny PlayStation 4 bundle. That will be a Glacier White PlayStation 4. There you go, two birds, one stone.
Yep, Glock said in Chatango after we got off about how Microsoft went black, Sony went white.
Yeah. Then we got a tease and a trailer for Order 1886. February 20, 2015 is when we're going to get a release for this not co-op game. Yeah, a lot of Nintendo stuff is 2015, too.
Yeah, I mean, in the early part of 2015, that kind of seems like a late release.
Yeah.
I mean, all honesty, I can understand some games targeting that time frame. Because it's after the holidays, more people are going to be able to have the spare cash laying around to do something.
Yeah.
But it still seems like a light release.
Yeah. But, Order 1886 looks good, but, hope it's got something. Oh. I'm still just disappointed that it's not co-op, when it was so kind of building towards that co-op idea.
Yeah.
Granted, we're getting a lot of other co-op games, so they might have dropped it in favor of a single-player experience.
Yeah, but just still, because, I would think that a co-op experience would fit it better.
Alright. Next up, we've got Intertwine. Tell about a bird and a fish that are in love, but can never beat the... Wait a minute. Is this Romeo with a bird and a fish?
You do realize we're going to have to watch the trailer.
I know, but I'm like, wait a minute.
In light Romeo's... of that right there, we are going to have to watch it.
Hi, JJZWFL, sorry. Mm-hmm. Sorry about not saying hi, or just, I was like, wait, okay.
Yeah, we were kind of in shock about Intertwined.
Yes. Love between a bird and a fish. Give him credit, that's different. The control both characters both simultaneously over the course of 90 lifetimes on a journey to... Wait, what?
Huh?
Okay, I'll reread the sentence.
Yeah.
You can guide them both simultaneously over the course of 9 unique lifetimes on a journey to unite their souls? Oh, okay. Why was that not the first sentence? Because that sounds a lot more interesting. Granted, I think... What was the name of the movie? I know a movie recently played with that idea. What was it? Don't remember.
I don't remember either.
Alright. Let's take a look at this.
Let's take a look at this weird trailer.
Alright. Start up in 3... 2, 1, go.
You're answering. Never mind.
I was going to say, a lot on the week. What? Okay. I thought my video froze for a second. But yeah, we do a lot of bi-weekly streams here on the, and on weekly streams on YouTube. That's that. We're getting a lot more productive with it.
One of those we're aiming to stream a lot more, but it's just making sure we both have the time to do it.
Yes. And if okay, I'm having your usual thing with videos.
Oh, choppy.
No, a lot of freeze framey.
Oh.
It'll play for a bit, and then I get a freeze frame, but I still hear the audio, so it's still going. It looks, kinda reminds me of, maybe something that script will help. Reminds me of, what the words I'm looking for? I don't know. I can't think of the words at the moment, but it reminds me of something. Can't know how to describe it. Kind of, what's the word for it? You're, top-down shooters a bit?
Yeah, kind of like that.
Yeah. Not really, JJ. Okay, I will say, got an interesting concept to it. I want to say it sounds like an indie title. Did you catch who was doing it?
No, don't think I did.
Because this seems like an indie-style game, because you get a lot more, I know this sounds like a negative, but kind of more artistic type, kind of artsy titles? More artistic-looking titles?
Right.
And this seems like a more artistic game than it is a kind of a traditional game, although that sounds weird saying. But yeah. No, this looks like an in-house one.
Really?
Yeah, it looks like an in-house one. Wow, that's surprising.
Huh.
It's got an interesting concept to it. Gameplay-wise, it looks a bit basic, but I assume there's a lot more to it than what I saw.
Oh, I would assume.
Yeah. Alright. We're going to move on to our, another DLC announcement. Infamous First Light.
Boy, a lot of DLC coming up.
Yeah. Alright, coming in August. Infamous First Light. Locked up in a prison for superpowered humans. Fetch Welker is forced to relive tragedies from her past. Unravel her dark secrets in Seattle while battling to escape snowy Curdon City and vengeance against those who wronged her. I believe this is one of the characters you meet in Second Son. I want to say. I have not played Second Son, but I want to say it is. Oh, shit. Alright. pull this over to the proper YouTube page, because I'm getting, stop script every, 30 seconds.
Oh, God.
Firefox is not handling that page very well. I might have made a huge mistake.
Firefox doesn't like Flash. Not the recent updates, anyhow.
I know. Chrome. Yeah, I know Firefox and Flash have not been on best of terms recently.
It's been since they tried to do what Chrome does. I don't know if Firefox is trying to embed Flash, and then you've also got the external Flash. Because, see, that's what Chrome does. Chrome has Flash built into it. So I don't know if Firefox tried to do that and that's what's screwing it up, or what.
Wait, does Opera have internal Flash too?
Uh-uh. No.
It's external. I was wondering that because when I full screen a video on Firefox, usually I'll have a separate tab for just Flash, but I don't have that for Opera. It's just an Opera.
It probably runs it as a process for Opera. But, anyhow. Infamous First Light announced trailer. You queued up?
Hang on.
I take that as a no.
The Firefox just locked down on me.
That's why I switched back to Chrome. And said, fuck Firefox. Literally.
All right.
I believe it was on one of the TGS streams that I proceeded to say fuck Firefox.
Yeah, I think it was three shows ago? I want to say.
I think.
All right. I'm ready.
All right.
All right. This up then in 3, 2, 1, go.
May contain content inappropriate for children.
Okay, now that's just an odd tweet. Or an odd wording for that tweet. Bloodbane, which we'll get to here in a bit, is apparently the spiritual sequel to Dead Cell, the Demon Soul. Wait.
What you've been through is unimaginable. But I can't help you unless you open up. Miss Walker. Miss Walker.
Fetch!
Please, tell me what happened. Oh, God, Brent.
That looks interesting. Now, what I understand about Second Son, this seems like an easy DLC for them to do. Because one of the things about the main character for Second Son is that you can absorb the powers of other characters.
Right.
So, all her powers are already in the game. Because you could get them as the main character of theirs, so... Seems like an easy DLC to pull off, and... I think you'll give insight to one of the new characters for Second Son.
Yeah.
Next up, something that I'm definitely excited for. Little Big Planet 3. the franchise is back in November. New cast of playable characters and the big handcrafted adventure. Well, the biggest handcrafted adventure yet. Backward compatible for existing user creations in Little Big Planet 1 and 2. So that means... Whoa. Guess how many just think of how many levels you're going to get to play out of the box. Without anyone having to create anything within Little Big Planet 3. Just out of the box.
Jeez.
Yeah, that...
Talk about a game worth the $60.
Yeah.
That's one of those where literally anyone that has not hopped on Little Big Planet... That's going to be the one that'll pull them in.
Yeah. Because, and just to let you know, Little Big Planet 2 did that as well. Everything that was playable in Little Big Planet 1, playable in Little Big Planet 2.
Yeah, but you think, really? 2 helped build the hype.
Mm-hmm.
I have a feeling with 3 allowing backwards compatibility with the past 2 games,
yeah.
That's liable to turn the whole franchise... even bigger.
Yeah. And this is what also why I keep saying that Project Spark is Microsoft's take on Little Big Planet, because at the core, they both are essentially the same idea.
Yeah.
User-generated content just pushed to the limit. Where you can literally create anything. And people have.
I think the only difference is Project Spark is a little more focused towards, like, game creators.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas Little Big Planet's more like how Forge World is in Halo. It's kind of just there for the fun.
Yeah. And, if you're wondering how far people can go with this, someone made the original Legend of Zelda... completely playable in the game.
Really?
Yes.
Holy shit.
You literally can play Legend of Zelda as it was originally in Little Big Planet 2, I believe.
Holy shit.
That is how far you can go with this. Go with Little Big Planet. Is you can literally recreate maybe older games in this game.
Huh.
And And this game is originally a platformer. A very classic platformer.
Hmm.
Yeah, I was surprised when I saw that, because I'm like, what? I know people could do amazing things with Little Big Planet, but that just made me go, wow. Wow.
No doubt.
To be able to literally recreate the game. Like, I don't just mean gameplay-wise. I mean look, sound, everything.
Huh.
It looked like you were playing the original Legend of Zelda. Yeah, let's look at the new Little Big Planet and see what they're bringing to the table this time around.
Let's do it.
Starting up then in 3, 2, 1, go. I can already see where people are gonna go with this one. I'm gonna have to open up every video on the YouTube page because, I'm getting stop and go a little bit. Fuck all.
Huh.
Yeah, I did, yeah. Having different characters now, Ooh, people are gonna take full advantage of that. That makes me excited because I have a Little Big Planet 1 and 2. Maybe get back to those one of these days.
You're gonna wind up getting 3.
I know. I swear, PlayStation 4 is like the next thing next gen wise for me. Like, unfortunately, Xbox One, I don't know, it's just doesn't have that many things exclusive to it that's pulling me towards it.
Right now, there's two things that they have going for it that have my attention.
Mm-hmm.
And I kind of hope that that builds, but if not, I'm probably just going to bite it and do it anyhow. But, yeah. Obviously, Halo stuff.
Yeah. Hey, that's definitely there for me.
Yeah. And, you know, in all seriousness, I'm not going to turn my back as far as Halo 5 goes. I know I've said I'm not going to pre-order it unless they can just surprise the hell out of me, and that's going to stand true. Yeah. I might buy it at release, but I'm not going to pre-order it. Unless they fix the multiplayer big time.
Yeah.
I mean, that's all there is to it. And in all seriousness, you were saying about PS4 being the next for you.
Yeah.
Honestly, I'm at a toss-up right now. Because I've seen stuff for PS4 that I've thought, that looks awesome. And then...
Yeah.
Now... what 343 is actually managing to do instead of bombing with Halo.
Yeah.
It's like, now you both made it a little hard now.
Yeah.
I almost feel like right now I'm back at the same spot we were kind of at last E3 Only this time I've actually got a little bit of stuff for both consoles. And it's like...
Yeah. Yeah. I was thinking that this year would be a big decider for a lot of people who might be hung up on... I don't know about the PlayStation 4. I don't know about the Xbox One. I don't know if I want to buy them yet. This year will probably help a lot of people go, I want that console, or I want that box.
Thank you, JJMB24, for following us.
Yeah, thanks. All right. next up, something I mentioned like 12 seconds ago.
Yes.
From Software is bringing out the PlayStation 4 exclusive Bloodborne. Let's see. You're searching for answers in the ancient city of Yharnam.
Yeah.
Okay. Now cursed with strange endemic illness, spreading through the streets and like wildfire, danger, death, and madness lurk around every corner of this dark, horrific world. You must discover its darkest secrets in order to survive. Now, I said earlier, I got a tweet saying that Bloodborne was essentially the spiritual secret, the spiritual successor to Demon's Souls. Which, if you don't know what that is, that was From Software's original big hit, in a way. And if you know Dark Souls, you essentially know Demon's Souls, because Dark Souls is really the spiritual successor to Demon's Souls, except it's multi-platform. Now, the reason they didn't do a Demon's Souls 2 is because Sony actually owns the rights to Demon's Souls.
Huh.
So I guess Bloodborne is the spiritual successor in that aspect, and that it's PlayStation 4 exclusive. Although, from what I saw, this...
This is the second Demon's Souls, essentially.
Yes. And from what I saw, it is very much in the style of both Souls games. Because I believe this is Project X.
Hmm.
We're talking about what Sony debuted last night. We're up to the Bloodborne debut. We'll be taking a look at the trailer. Alright, now I have to remember, don't play a YouTube video on the page, because it will break something. Terribly. Alright, y'all queued up?
Queued up.
Alright, taking a look at the trailer then, in 3, 2, 1, go.
May contain content inappropriate for children.
And also from what I've heard, this is Project Beast. The thing that got leaked, I want to say, like, 2 weeks ago? 2 to 3 weeks ago, I want to say, is when Project Beast got leaked.
Did we cover it on TGS or not?
I don't think we did, because I think it happened, like, right around we did our last show.
Ah.
Well, it's definitely their style of game. Dark, dreary, bit gothic. Essentially, not colorful. And not happy. Checking me on YouTube. A zombie dog? I don't think you can full screen the video, can you, Tommy?
I can, but it won't work out too well. Okay, good. I did not show up.
Oh.
I just got an email notification.
Oh. And dog was cut in, I think? A little bit more modern than what they've done.
Yeah.
Which should be interesting, because Demon Souls and Dark Souls are very much more medieval-esque time period. It's more a kind of a swords and sorcery kind of setting. This looks more, I don't know, Victorian age? Yes, yeah, it's a beautiful game. Yeah.
Like I said, I can full screen, but I don't know how well it'll work.
Yeah.
That's the only downside.
I think, might have to set up a separate screen region, because I believe it would be a new tab then.
Yeah. That'd be something I'd have to test out to see.
Yeah, sorry about that, but... Alright.
It's a shame their embed doesn't give you the bigger, player.
Yeah. Alright. Next up, coming off its debut at the Ubisoft press conference, we got more Far Cry 4, and by Far Cry 4, I mean actual Far Cry 4 gameplay instead of the 5-minute cinematic we got at Ubisoft press conference. Yay. Alright. Look at that, then. See how the new Far Cry is looking. Wait a minute. Hang on. Looking at something real quick for the next one. If that's what I think it is... Hello, Justin Burr. Okay. Wait a minute. That is not 2. That's 3. Okay. Guess we're not counting that second one.
Okay.
All right. Get up and ready for Far Cry.
Uh-huh.
Alright, take a look at that then in 3, 2, 1, go.
Hi everyone, my name's Alex Hutchinson, creative director on Far Cry 4.
I'm Mark Thompson, I'm the narrative director on Far Cry 4. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well, and welcome to Karat, our new fictional location. So in Far Cry 4, you step into the shoes of A.J. Gale, who is returning to the country of his birth, initially just to scatter his mother's ashes before he gets caught up in what's essentially a civil war.
Karat is a fictional place based somewhere in the Himalayas, inspired by places like Nepal and Bhutan, and a bunch of countries from that part of the world.
So looking out there, you know, one of the core things of any open world game, that sort of excitement and mystique and hope of an open world is, you know, what is all that smoke coming from? You know, what temples are out there? What secret locations? So we've peppered the world with different places to find.
I'm not gonna lie, this game looks
all
gorgeous.
Of them filled with loot, yes. And secrets and collectibles. Granted,
you could say that about just everything
that
showed up at E3 this year. So it looks gorgeous, but yeah,
densely populated with a variety of different animals,
beasts. And also that's some kind of yak. I don't even know what that animal was.
Yak, I believe.
Is it a yak?
With next-gen fur.
Next-gen fur, that's true.
Next-gen fur.
Individually modeled hairs.
So you see here with with the eagle, you won't see it in this demo, but you can be attacked from above for the first time in a Far Cry game. So we've tried really to play with verticality, to have threats above and below you.
And obviously you can still get involved in the ecosystem of the animals and hunt. And
you can throw bait now.
Yes, to attract animals.
There goes a...
Yeah, and stuff like the eagle stealing the burrell of the goat.
That's what I was about to say. I was like,
that bird
just get a goat?
That's just what happens at the intersection of those two different AI systems talking to each other.
The goal being that every player tells themselves a different story, that they get different surprises, that they have a different story to tell their buddies when they come to work the next day or go back to school or whatever. So there are a bunch of new tools in Far Cry 4, one of which you'll see here is the grapple. We wanted to make something that allowed you
to climb over those
annoying cliffs you sometimes came across in Far Cry 3, and something that would also lean into the much more vertical, much more mountainous regions we were building in this game.
That's going to become the new
and then one,
bow and
was a pretty
arrow
simple example,
from,
but the level designers get pretty crafty with the setup.
Probably. We have these areas we're calling adventure zones in the new game, which will take you to places like temples, which
I
you can see from afar.
Yeah,
and
2 years ago with
the
whole bow and arrow.
Sort of,
yeah,
you know,
everything.
Interesting and
we hit
a different
way. Everything.
Well, you gotta get up on that craze of, what was it, Hunger Games came out around that time? And it hit big?
Yeah.
Which I think is, which I think is funny because Avengers came out before that and you had Hawkeye in there, but
that we've introduced for Far Cry 4, it adds a little more versatility than the bow did in Far Cry 3. Obviously, it sacrifices the long range
crossbow
for rapid fire.
I know. It's like no,
as we were talking about
weapon
it.
Yeah, isn't this all convenient?
This is one of my favorite bits. This, if you look down when you're meleeing in the new game, you kick, so you can do all kinds of fun setups such as that.
Oh wow!
Kicking things is hilarious. I expect people around the world to be kicking rocks, explosive barrels, dead bodies come November.
All the explosions! 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 Explosions!
Our goal really was just to provide as many tools as possible, whether vehicles or animals.
I love this demo. It's just
or,
him
you know,
running around
goofy
doing
stuff
things
and let people fit them together
any
way they
story
want.
Yeah. And we've snuck a few features
yeah
in.
Yeah, there's no story. There's no objective. There's just here's a bunch of stuff randomly happening.
So drive and shoot. Obviously, it's a bit frustrating to be chasing someone forever and have to sort of drive in front of them, pull over, and wait for them to get out. So now in the vehicles, you can drive and shoot with any one-handed weapon. And you can also do driving takedowns from any vehicle, which I really like. So
whoa,
this idea of leaping from your vehicle into another vehicle, do horrible things to them, boot them out the side, and then continue.
Eventually,
on
Hollywood
way
it up, son.
And now deliver death without even leaving your seat. So wingsuit is still here, and it's really cool, as you see. And actually, when the space became more vertical, it actually became more fun.
The mountainous environment means that there's a lot more wingsuiting to be found.
And hopefully you won't get it before the middle of the game. You
yes
will. Hopefully you will get it
yes
before the middle of the game. That's the current plan. But
we are
many
we have to wait
from,
half the game to get this?
Watching you guys abuse this online.
Oh my god. Hopefully you won't get it before half the game. Or hopefully you will get it before half the game.
Yeah.
So here you'll get a look at elephants. Elephants are awesome. Probably my favorite animal in the game. Weaponized in many different ways. You can drive them into a rage, watch them smash the other characters in the world, or you can clamber on top of one and drive it through the gate yourself.
My favorite animal is the human animal.
It's very Far Cry 2 of you, Mark.
Oh, it's the shark of darkness.
So co-op is a massive part of the new game. It's one of our big ways of opening up the open world and letting you play any way you want. So basically, when you ask your buddy to join, all the solo missions turn off.
Wait, what is he hanging
and you're
on
left
to
with all of the open world toy, the outposts, the fortresses, the towers?
Yeah, I don't think there's
the
really anything
to play
for him to be on in that world of purpose.
And all
the,
that progress will be saved within your game, so you don't have to go into another mode, you don't have to leave your game, and you don't feel like you're wasting your time.
Huh.
All right, let's do this.
What do you think of the buzzer, Mark, which is a small one-man helicopter?
It's very red. No, but it's cool because it gives like this almost like developer perspective on the world. Like you normally in Far Cry 3 you could never really see an outpost, or you couldn't engage with an outpost from this kind of vantage point, which is really cool. So the outposts from Far Cry 3 were like the template for the fortresses.
And
they're kind
the,
of like
the elephant ain't having any
bigger,
of this shit.
Better, more badass version of the outpost to a more bad. To paraphrase
just comes
Cookie
over
B,
there, picks him up, smashes him on the ground. Like, fuck you.
So imagine charging that vehicle, you know, atop the elephant as opposed to just watching it happen.
Up there goes that
we
car.
A lot of money on that feature.
Yeah, a lot of money.
Perhaps we could have put that in a video.
Very expensive.
Evan's like, how dare you interrupt my piece?
So thanks everyone for watching. We really appreciate your time, and we look forward to showing you a whole lot more gameplay in the coming months. The game ships, of course, November 18th worldwide.
The Inception noise.
Pre-order now for a free upgrade to the limited edition. includes 3 extra story missions and a bonus Impaler harpoon gun. Pre-order now.
Wait,
Far Cry 4.
Wouldn't that be something you'd
available
want
November 18th, 2014.
A harpoon gun out up in the Alps doesn't sound that useful. Outside of just having something to harpoon people with.
Yeah, I kind of got to agree with you on that one.
All right. Next up, I guess we have the official sequel to Dead Island, even though there's Dead Island Riptide.
Yeah, but now we've got a numbered sequel.
That really count?
Yes.
Dead Island 2, parentheses 3, got announced as well. We're heading to the Golden State, which is... what is Golden State?
I don't remember.
I don't remember at this point. Anyway, coming spring 2015.
Oh, you know, you were saying about how it had to have the number with it?
Yeah, yeah.
Well, is Halo Reach considered a sequel?
It's a prequel.
So say?
Well, I don't think Riptide was a sequel or a prequel. Well, I don't know. I don't think it was a prequel. Alright, you have to give me 1 second. I'm switching over to Opera for this, because the things ain't working.
Sounds like you need Chrome.
I'm still getting script things, even though I'm not.
Wow.
On the page playing any video, so.
Your computer just hates you.
Yeah, it kind of is. Be moving a little bit smoother. Alrighty then. Y'all queued up and ready? Taking a look at Dead Island 2, parentheses 3, and 3, 2, 1, Gahoo!
You're gonna just do that every time, aren't you?
Yes. That'll be my joke for Dead Island. But, kinda surprised this is getting a sequel, because I didn't think either Dead Islands went over that well.
I didn't really think they did.
Well then.
Just completely ignoring everything.
Yep, just in his own little world of, hey, I got music, I'm doing my run, zombie apocalypse totally isn't happening around me. Nope, totally can't hear it. Totally can't hear it.
God, this guy's fucking lucky.
Also, he does not give a shit. Of course, he's already bit, so he's like, fuck it, I'm going on one last run before I can turn. Huh. Ah, that not iPod has got some damn good battery life. Dragging a broom, or is that broom attached to her? I can't tell. It doesn't look like she's dragging a broom, but there's a broom brush right behind her.
Seriously, bro? Sweet!
Mods, you're time to split. Freaking awesome!
Jack, wait, is that Jack Black? Was that just me, or was that Jack Black?
I don't know.
Because it sounded like him.
Couldn't hardly hear it, so.
Yeah. That's kind of from a couple of the the vocal tics he has for certain characters. So yeah, that I'm leading a sequel, which is kind of surprising. Maybe it's just me thinking that Dead Island didn't go over that well.
Maybe
it found its audience.
I didn't think it did either, but maybe it did.
Yeah. Maybe it found its audience.
Maybe.
All right. Next up, three quick things. Last of Us beginning an appearance in Diablo 3 with Clickers, Lurkers, Infected getting to appear in the new Diablo game. And by new, I mean it's like 2 years old now. Or it's at least a year old. New multiplayer stuff for Battlefield Hardline, which we already took a look at yesterday.
Yep.
Disney Infinity! Is teaming up with Sony for an exclusive little collector's edition for PlayStation 3 and PlayStation 4, where the Incredible Hulk will only be available at launch on PlayStation.
At launch.
Yeah.
So he'll be a DLC pack after a little bit.
Yeah, he'll get his own little special thing, like, once down the road for every other console.
Yeah.
Which, that's surprising they threw out Hulk as the exclusive. I would think they would do that for Hawkeye.
You gotta think, though, how much of a draw would it be if you had Hawkeye as opposed to Hulk?
Yeah.
A lot of people are gonna want to try to complete the set, so there you'd be.
Yeah. Seems like it's only the Avengers lineup at the moment, plus Spider-Man. Although they haven't, I don't think they've confirmed anyone, like, figure-wise, outside of someone that was a part of Avengers. Next up, our indie showcase. As we got a look at Broforce, Hotline Miami 2, Wrong Number, Not a Hero, Titan Souls, The Talos Principle, and the sequel to the multi-million dollar selling PC game, Magicka 2. And I think more because I don't see a Devolver Digital in there. Yeah, I don't see Devolver Digital in there. Oh, yeah, also partnerships with both Devolver Digital and Paradox Interactive. Yeah. Shall we take a look at the little Developer Digital and PlayStation lineup?
We shall. Once it queues up. Thank you. Flash tried to lock up for a second there. That's why I was like, once it queues up.
Alright, then. Taking a look at it then in 3, 2, 1, go! Oh, you don't know what Broforce is, do you? You know all those, 90s characters, like, you know, all those 90s movies that starred, like, Schwarzenegger and Stallone?
Yeah.
Like, all those kind of characters? Put them all playable in one game, and that's Broforce. And Not a Hero looks to be going off the same idea.
I wonder, will you love us for having created you? Will the world you build be like ours, or so different that we today cannot even imagine it?
Your will is free because you were made to be free. Let your will be done.
Okay, that definitely looks like your normal artsy indie title. Got a tweet, and so I'll look over this real quick just to see if there's anything new. Just another couple quick notes on Bloodborne, since I just got a tweet about it. Looks to be faster in combat than presented in Demon's Souls. Gone is the block than attack style previously used, and combat will focus more on quick melee fighting and guns. And yes, Project Beast was Bloodborne, so yeah. Moving on then. Next up, Grand Fandango Remastered is coming to both PlayStation 4 and PlayStation Vita, which I'm sure a lot of people will be happy about that. Honestly, I've never played Grim Fandango. I'm only aware of that in the other... I believe that was Lucas... Was that LucasArts? I don't think... No. Oh, wait, no, it's a Tim Schafer, so yeah. Yeah, it is, because Tim Schafer was a part of LucasArts back in the day.
Ah.
And that's a Tim Schafer game. We also got Let It Die, exclusively for PlayStation 4 by Suda51. Console debut of... Abzu? And a demo of No Man's Sky when it will launch first on PlayStation 4.
Right.
Which... believe... Yeah, we covered No Man's Sky before.
Yeah. That one sounds familiar.
Yeah, because that's that, like, open-world galaxy-spanning game that's made, like, by, like, I think, like, five people.
Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah, because I got a debut at, want to say last year's VGAs when we got our first look at that.
Yeah.
See what this Let It Die is. Y'all kid have been ready?
Yeah, when my Flash player decides it wants to cooperate.
Flash is not happy with us tonight, is it? It's just not. No. Any way, shape, or form. Flash being cooperative now?
Yes.
Alright then. Taking a look at the Let It Die trailer in 3, 2, 1, go.
Death cancels everything except the truth.
Wow, this is really realistic gameplay. Like, this is like photorealism, man. Okay, you know what this is reminding me of?
What?
Manhunt. Essentially, you were this guy that was put into this killer be killed game by the serial killer. It kind of reminds me in terms of a premise. It looks like to be some type of death game, something or another. That's just might be me then. All right. Okay, I swear if this is that one thing that's on, I think the Saturn, I'm done.
Which one?
Abzu.
Oh God.
I can't think of the name off the top of my head, but that thing. Because I don't think we need another one of those.
You talking about Echo?
No. I'm talking about the thing where you raise the fish that could talk to you.
Oh, no, I don't know that.
I don't remember the name for it. Yeah, let's see what Abzu is, since I've never gotten to talk about it before. Get all queued up and ready?
Uh-huh.
All right, take a look at it then in 3, 2, 1, yoo-hoo.
funny, Flash will take its time on starting up, but it has not screwed the video up yet.
Fish. Swimming. Little blue sea. Is this Fish Simulator 2015?
Well, we need one.
Hello, giant mech in the middle of the ocean.
That's scared of the...
He's like, I'm gonna sneak up on you. Boo! Bye! Looks like an artsy game. Sony's got a lot of artistic games on show, didn't show apparently.
Yeah.
It's like, what's going on in the game? I don't know. You're walking around on the seafloor saying hi to fish. And giant mechs, it looks like, and that's kind of it. Moving on from there, SEA President and CEO Sean Layden announced that YouTube is coming to PlayStation 4 later this year. You'll be able to share your gameplay videos straight to YouTube with a tap of the share button. Bonus for anyone who pretty much upsells to YouTube. They got the streaming down, and they got the uploading down. Almost like they're trying to make the PlayStation 4 into pretty much a capture device.
They are.
The 25 free-to-play games heading to PlayStation 4 this year. We got PlanetSide 2, Kingdom Under Fire 2, Loadout, My Singing Monsters, and more. PlanetSide 2 is already free-to-play, but yeah, guess you can get free-to-play across the board. PSN Now will be available in continental United States and part of Canada this summer. Well, parts of Canada. July 31st, SEA will introduce an open beta where gamers located in supported areas will also be able to rent over 100 PlayStation 3 titles. Beta lineup includes Ground Zeroes, God of War Ascension, Ultra Street Fighter 4, and more. Probably not your best ones.
No.
I believe Far Cry 4 is for the PlayStation 4. Yes, it is. Wait a minute. I just read that. Okay.
More than likely, no. Because yes. Usually cross-platform doesn't work.
Yeah, cross-platform doesn't like to work. But you can... buy Far Cry 4 on the PS4 or PlayStation 3, you can invite your friends to play on PSN even if they don't have the game. Oh no. A bit trickier. I don't think they've confirmed any type of cross, like even same company cross-platform play, have they?
I don't think I've heard anything, but... Yeah. There again, a lot of this that's coming out right now is more just the groundwork for the game.
Yeah.
A lot of the questions like that right there, I have a feeling, is going to be asked between now and release, which is then going to turn into the whole getting all the answers we needed.
Yeah. Yeah, as far as I know, they haven't answered any questions about any type of cross-platform.
Yeah.
gonna say if you want probably a more single player experience, I'd say go Far Cry 4. If you're looking for a more co-op borderline MMO experience, go Destiny.
And also thank you for joining, for following Yolo Party.
Yes, thank you.
Not joining, damn it. Yeah. Words.
I mean, other than that, I don't know. We've seen a lot more of Destiny than we've seen of Far Cry 4, because we're just now seeing gameplay for it.
Honestly, that one is a tough one to call. Yeah.
Say, depending on what you really want, pick from there. Otherwise, flip a coin, because you're getting what looks to be too good a good game no matter what.
Either that or do the smart thing and figure out which one you can have more fun with friends on.
Yes.
Because from the looks of it, right now, both of them, they're getting up there now.
Yeah. I have access to a PlayStation 4. I personally don't have one. My uncle's got a PlayStation 4.
And but I've gotten don't have a PS4 either, so.
But I have a little bit experience with it. Just a little bit. 2 hours and
user joined your channel.
Like an hour and a half.
Hello, Glock.
Hey, y'all.
welcome to the show. An hour in, Glock.
Sorry, I was at work.
No, okay. That's what we figured.
We kind of figured that.
Yeah.
Yeah. I got off at 9 o'clock. I ate there. It took me about 30 minutes to eat, so I left at about 9:30.
Yeah, we just. If I do, I will remember to do so. That might be,
Oh, just a warning. Friday, I will be working from 5 to 11.
Okay.
I was thinking you were going to say something about it, because I heard a conversation involving that.
Yeah. I work from 5 to 11 Friday. I think 5 to 11 Saturday. Sunday, I'm going to be working from 5 to 9. 5 is their love. The 5 is the number that they love, apparently.
Yellow, more than likely, Pace will wind up getting a PS4, so, yeah. When he gets one, we'll try to remember that.
Yeah. Yellow Party was asking, saying that I should get a PS4 and add him on.
Why do you need to get a PS4?
Yeah, you make a good point there, Yolo. They both do look fun.
Yeah.
Both co-op and
solo.
Come on!
Sunset Overdrive isn't on PS4.
Hey, right now Yolo's talking about Far Cry and Destiny.
Yeah.
That's a tough call.
Yeah.
You've got COD on Xbox. It looks so amazing, and it's first on Xbox.
Smash on the fish.
I'm sorry. I don't like the fish. I don't like the fish.
3DS hacked. As far as I know, not really. I don't think. As far as I know, 3DS isn't. Really, has it really been hacked yet to any real degree? But anyway, back on what we're talking about. PlayStation 4, the Sunday conference. Glad you'll be able to help us out on this one.
All right, where are we at?
PSTV.
Oh, okay. PlayStation Now. That what you're talking about?
PS Now. I started to correct myself and say PSN, and then it's like, wait, no. I was saying
nope,
it right
completely different
with.
Thing, even though they shared letters.
That was one of those I started to, and then it's like, wait, nope. I was saying it right to begin with. Don't.
Yeah.
There you go.
PSN TV will be finally coming to the North American market. $99. People will be able to download. Select PSP Vita titles, PSP titles, PlayStation games from PlayStation 1 Classics through the PlayStation Store. Stream select PS3 games to the device via PSN Now. And play PS4 games for a PS4 system in their home over local Wi-Fi through Remote Play.
Alright. Thank you for the forums.
Select Vita games will also be playable on PSTV via Vita cards. Bundle including DualShock 3 is also coming. It's also available for $139.
So
this
is this essentially going to be along the same lines as what Steam's wanting to do with the Steam machines?
I want to say this is a. This was the thing that would allow anyone to stream PSP titles with the Vita.
Okay, so what are we on?
Scroll on down to the PSTV. That should be the first thing you see for a paragraph.
But you see what I'm saying there. The way it's showing that, it's showing...
Five. I only see five.
Oh, first one.
First one? Okay.
Yeah, first one, scroll down to the PSTV with stuff.
The way it's kind of showing... This, in my opinion, anyhow, is like you can download stuff from the older consoles and the Vita.
Yeah.
On this, as well as being able to stream PS3 and PS4 games straight on it.
Yeah.
So,
but what
it's kind of putting me in the mindset of the Steam machines.
Yeah.
What I meant, it's a case of you can do all this on your TV without actually having to have all these different consoles right there.
Yeah. What I was meaning was, I believe this was Vita TV that came out in Japan, and this would allow you to essentially capture footage for the Vita. And if you can capture footage, you can stream footage.
Right.
So this would allow anyone with a Vita to stream anything that's a PSP title. So this is cool to hear. Of course, I don't have a Vita, so that kind of doesn't help. And since 2.5 is coming out, anyone who would want to stream Birth by Sleep, well, you have another way of doing so and actually look better and probably perform better, too.
Probably.
Because I think even with the really big install, I don't think Birth by Sleep still had its kind of long loading moments. So yeah. Vita TV coming over stateside as a PSTV. Next up.
Sorry, I'm trying to fix my keyboard.
I was wondering what you were trying to do to it.
Why are you trying to fix your keyboard by banging on it? That sounds
because
like a terrible
idea. Some of the keys get stuck sometimes and I have to pop them back into place.
So banging on it works?
Yes.
Just pull up on the key?
No, it doesn't work like that. I mean, like, when it gets stuck, when you try to press it, it won't go down. It gets stuck up. You have to actually hit it to get it to go down.
Oh, okay. The reverse of what I was thinking. What's going on?
Well, then that's when you take the laptop and you smash it on the ground.
Yes.
And get a new one.
Yes. Alrighty then. We shall see the new Mortal Kombat, well, the debut of the Mortal Kombat gameplay, really.
I want to see. That game looks fun.
Right under the PSTV stuff.
I'm looking Far Cry, Dead Island, Battlefield Hardline, Grim Fandango, Let It Die. Oh, y'all saw the Let It Die?
Yes, keep going.
Yes. Glock it. Go past everything, because we've already talked about that, unless you want to say something about it.
I'm back. So, what did y'all think about Let It Die?
Kind of reminded me of Manhunt. And kind of a style of the game. I don't know. It seems like it's kind of on that same idea path as Manhunt is. We can now bring the roster for Smash Bros. 233. We'll get to that here in a bit.
Really?
Yes. We got two character announcements.
Jeez.
Like just now.
Jeez.
Which, as I said before, what one of the characters is, you can essentially make the roster infinity at this point. Alright, we all queued up for Mortal Kombat?
Hang on. Yep, okay.
Alright, Take a look at the Mortal Kombat gameplay debut in 3, 2, 1.
Stupid full
go.
Who's next?
Why are we ripping off Goldberg's catchphrase? What the hell?
I will relieve you of your burden.
You offend this one, Thera.
Are they bringing in new characters or something?
Yeah, those are two brand new characters.
Okay.
Like, brand new characters.
I was wondering about that. I was wondering if it was just like a remastered character, just like, you know, you can't recognize them at all because it looks completely different.
No, we've never, as far as I know, we've never had anyone associated really with Bugs or two characters in one in Mortal Kombat. As far as I know. And the most I have with previous Mortal Kombat outside of 9 is the wiki reading. Although I think this is another continuity reboot. I think. I still hope we get a callback to the trailer. Looks to be a lot of environmental interactions, which is something I think they're bringing over really from Injustice.
Gonna more be so. Legit. Yes, I brought it back again.
I need a counter for that by the end of this week.
You need a counter for legit?
Yeah.
It's just for E3. Everything else, I will not use that word for. But E3, I will use that word for because I can't. Ow! Wait, they brought back the X-ray stuff! Yay!
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah. When I was playing this trailer, when I was looking at this trailer and my uncle was over, he was like, well, there's the finishing move. I'm like, no, that's just the x-rays. It's not even the fatalities.
Oh, no. Oh!
Finish him.
And the fatalities are even worse.
And third new character.
Fatality.
Who's next?
Yeah. Again, why are they ripping off Goldberg's catchphrase? What the hell? Because that's his thing.
Well, who's next?
I guess that might be a thing for, like, who they're adding into this new roster, because me saying that this is another continuity reboot is not any kind of confirmed information. It's just a tweet somebody said based off the dialogue between Sub-Zero and oh my god, I'm forgetting his name. Scorpion! Dialogue between those two is very much classic of those characters, and if you know Mortal Kombat 9, you know, well, pretty much everyone's dead.
Yeah. 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 Well, technically, if you go through the Mortal Kombat series, everyone died a while back.
Because well, everyone died.
Everyone died in Armageddon. Like, everyone.
Yeah, everyone died in Armageddon. Mortal Kombat 9 was a continuity reboot, essentially, because it takes us through 1, 2, 3.
Yeah. Let's see, everyone died in, there was another one where they all died.
Think Deception.
Deception, yeah. Deception, they all died. So technically, everyone is dead.
Yeah.
Scorpion and Sub-Zero never die.
Fair enough. Scorpion never dies. He is, like, bred from hell now.
Yeah. Although,
Sub-Zero, I don't know. But
yeah, he's
that. Yeah.
Yeah, he died in 9, so this I guess it's a reboot. All right. Brian Michael Bendis, executive producer of Powers, then unveiled on stage the first details of the PlayStation Original Content series, available in the United States this December, with every PSN user in the United States receiving the first episode for free.
Can we skip this one? I want to see the next one more.
What, the Ratchet & Clank movie?
Uh huh.
Okay. I'm gonna guess there's nothing there because we only got like 36 seconds, and I assume all the information we need to know is in this there.
Probably.
Yeah. Alright.
Ratchet and Clank! Ratchet and Clank!
I think I'll hit everything else information-wise before we watch anything else. So, next up we got the Ratchet and Clank movie trailer, which is apparently a remake of the first game story.
It is, and it's going to be absolutely hilarious.
You know, it's really weird to say that and know what Ratchet's wearing, because he's wearing the Future Trilogy outfit he usually has. It's like, wait a minute.
Continuity, I don't care. It's Ratchet and Clank.
Well, it's a remake of the story. Meh. Next up we have The Last of Us Remastered coming to the PlayStation 4.
We're not watching the trailer?
I said go back through the information before we... I'm going to go over the information before we go back and watch stuff.
Oh, okay.
Help speed things up, if you'd listen.
Sorry.
Got a new trailer for Metal Gear Solid 5, The Phantom Pain, which... I can kind of see where it's a little hard to watch, but... Like, they kind of off-screen certain things. Kind of.
So that means they did, but they didn't really do a good job.
You still get the intention.
Yeah.
Grand Theft Auto 5 is also coming to the PlayStation 4, and your save will carry over from a PlayStation 3 version through what means, but you'll be able to carry over your save file. You just have to rebuy the game. Our first look at gameplay from an Arkham Knight. And finally, the official debut of Uncharted 4, A Thief's End. Which, if this is not going to be the end of the Uncharted franchise, I don't know what will.
Well, I mean, it's even got end in its name.
Yeah, and the Uncharted titles usually have a meaning to them.
Then again, it could be, you know, that he's not dying, he's just finally retiring after his final... biggest adventure.
Black, did you not watch that trailer?
I did.
He was retired before the game even starts. Alright, let's take a look at this.
I don't want him to die. I don't want him to die.
I don't think he'll die.
Nathan Drake can't die.
Yes, he can.
No,
he can't.
Have
you even played the Uncharted series?
Nope.
I have played one. I played the original Uncharted.
And you're the one out of all of us who's like, I hope Nathan Drake doesn't die.
Yeah.
Really? Really?
Gonna be nice.
I'm just pointing out that's odd because I'm the one here who's played all three games. That should be coming out of my mouth, not his. Anyway, let's take a look at the Ratchet & Clank movie trailer.
Hold on, let me get back up. Okay.
Wait, wait for Galactic to be ready.
I said okay.
Oh, I didn't hear that. Alright then, look at the trailer in 3, 2, 1, go.
Insomnia Game. Rainmaker.
I've always dreamt of being a Galactic Ranger. Doing big things like Captain Quark.
You don't have what it takes.
Wait, just give me a chance.
Sorry, no time. Galaxy in jeopardy. Get back out there. And remember, you can do anything.
You know, I would say it's great to see Quark and Quark being a dick, but Quark was always a dick. Oh, by the way, the movie's also getting a theatrical release.
Yeah, that is gonna show up on my mid-year review.
I will say, the one thing that's kind of weird to not see in this, unless it popped up right there at the end, the title, which I'm gonna look real quick before I say this, because I might be wrong... No, I'm not. There's no Omni wrench. There's no wrench in there at all. Which is odd because that's kind of the signature weapon of Ratchet.
There's no what?
The wrench is not in the game. Or not
Moon. Yes, not it is. Look at the ATC.
No. Wrench the weapon.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's what I meant. I don't mean the wrench in the logo. I mean the wrench that Ratchet uses and uses in every single game.
Oh, okay.
Like kind of his signature weapon.
Yeah.
It seems odd. Kind of. I don't know if that was a minor nitpick or a major nitpick. Because I wouldn't be truly that upset if the wrench is not there, as long as they introduce, like, other weaponry. Because the wrench is kind of the most boring weapon in the game. I say that because, well, if you've seen Sunset Overdrive and you think, oh, that's a really, like, kind of ridiculous weaponry. This is just an extended... Wait, where? I don't see Ratchet ever wielding it.
Huh.
I mean, I see the wrench in the logo, but that's not the wrench I'm talking about.
Yeah.
But, nah. Maybe it's in the movie. Doesn't get as much screen time.
Might be that.
We already saw the Dead Island 2 trailer. Trust me, Cliff.
That trailer was funny.
Yes. Alright. No reason to look at Last of Us, and apparently this got spoilers. I wonder what it's spoiling, then. Oh, please
don't. I don't know. I watched it, and I didn't get spoilers. I have no idea what's going on in the game.
Huh.
Looking. I'm kind of scanning through, seeing what exactly it's spoiling. Okay, it's got a whole... Okay, I know what's spoiling, then. Got a lot of the late-game stuff.
Ah.
Like, past the, kind of the changeover point. I'm trying to be vague on that one. Alright, let's take a look at this hard to watch, according to Kojima. Metal Gear Solid 5 Phantom Pain trailer.
Hold on, why is it hurt to watch?
That's what, Kojima said. Is this year's E3 trailer would be hard to watch. I kinda see it at points. But they do the old trick Hollywood does with very brutal things, and that they cut away
okay.
at the last second.
Yeah.
But they don't really cut away, as they kind of just move the camera just up or out of the way. So what is happening is off screen.
Okay. Let's do it.
Alrighty then. Taking a look at the new Phantom Pain trailer in 3, 2, 1, go.
May contain content inappropriate for children. Well.
Yeah. It opens with the dead bodies everywhere.
Well. Hi there, are you getting something to eat?
Why, yes. Yes, he is.
I'll get him in a second, Annie. Oh. Standing. On the edge, I'll be right back, guys. The crater,
man, I realize Big Boss had a ponytail.
Yes.
I swear none of the footage ever shows him in a ponytail until now.
Huh.
Granted, none of it's been from behind. Really, except like the original Phantom Pain stuff. I don't think he had a ponytail then. Whispers. Tell the tales of the brothers gone. I like how all the Phantom Pain trailers have had a musical piece to associate with it. What a mess we made when it all went wrong. Watching from the edge of
the circus for the games to begin. Gladiators.
Don't think that's healthy for you, Big Boss. Just saying. That somebody trying to impress was off Revolver Ocelot. And there's our not Ocelot. Not Ocelot, not Otacon. Even though he looks like Otacon. Okay, that just seemed... Are those two T's? Because you know that too about the Nats, don't you?
Yeah.
That... Because I want to say that's not... natural. Okay, that's the only time I think you don't see it, but the map is...
What did I miss?
Potential QTEs. Like, there's this unnatural sheen to every single knight that gets pulled out. And I'm not sure why. The only thing I can think of is QTEs or for dramatic purposes. And I... I think it'd be kind of dumb for dramatic purposes. Yeah, you see what I meant earlier, right?
Fuzzy Bear, please quit the chats like that, or I yes. will have no choice but to mute you.
Yes.
What's he doing?
He's tossing out the insults. Fuzzy, if you don't like what we're doing here, you can leave. Leave.
There's
plenty of other people who have plenty of more viewers doing things. So,
what insults is he tossing out?
Usual trolley things. That's why I didn't pay much mind to it, because it just sounds like trolling stuff. Fuzzy. Fuzzy, I'm gonna have to kindly ask you to edit. You
giving us advice on what?
Well, it doesn't sound like you're giving us advice. It's more so sound like you're just insulting us.
So it sounds like you're being a dick.
Yes.
And you know we don't tolerate dicks here.
Yes. Like I said, if you don't like what we're doing here, you can leave. You don't have to be here.
Thanks, Cliff.
Yes, thank you.
So, is Cliff gonna become a regular or something?
I don't know.
I guess he likes our show. Good, we have a regular. Okay. I'm taking it into my own hands.
No, you're not.
Oh.
You got it?
Okay.
You got it?
Two things, Fuzzy. One, you forgot your O. Second, it's not about us getting to the top. It's about us producing something that people like. One, if at least one person likes us, fine by me and my book. Yeah.
And Fuzzy, in about 10 minutes, when you get time to cool down, then you can try to come back.
Yeah. Hello, Legend of Steve.
Hey, Legend of Steve, what's up?
Yeah, we could have banned him a long time ago, but I figured it was just one stuff, and I was completely content to just ignore him.
I'm under the funny impression we save bans for the end of it.
Yeah.
We give them a timeout. If they can't figure it out from there, then
bans
the ban
are a
hammer
last
can come down.
Yeah.
Bans are a last resort.
Yeah, he just wants to troll, that's it.
Yeah.
There's no sense in catering
to him.
Yeah. That's why I was more than content to just ignore him. Just gonna ignore him, just roll with the show. I don't know if the GTA 5 PS4 trailer's got anything new to it. Let me real quick. Not really.
I doubt it.
Yeah.
Because it's just announcing that it is coming over to PS4, and like you said, the PS3
Xbox One is
going to get the save files transferred.
Yeah. Yep.
Legend, we're covering the rest of the Sony press conference and the Nintendo Direct that happened today, along with other E3 news.
Yep.
And yes, Cliff, it does, but you know.
Yeah.
You can get used to it after a little while.
It's almost...
Yep. Grand Theft Auto 5 coming PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and for those who were really, really petitioning for it, come for PC, folks, so...
Woohoo! I don't have a supercomputer, so I can't play those games on my computer.
I wouldn't think it would take like a supercomputer. I think it would take at least a decent computer to run GTA 5. I would think.
Probably take one better than Glock's potato, though.
My potato doesn't like games, apparently.
Aw.
You know as well as I do, his computer hates League. And that has to be like the low end of the totem pole when it comes to games.
I can play Skyrim.
But if you can play Skyrim, I'm sure you can play GTA 5, because,
For some reason, I can play Skyrim, but I can't play freaking Watch Dogs.
Oh. That's... Oh. You might have problems running GTA 5, then.
I think it's more of a case of, with Skyrim, you're playing solo, so it's only relying on your computer.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
Which, for processor, as far as a solo game, it isn't as utilizing.
Yeah.
When you're dealing with multiplayer, that eats processor.
Yeah. But having a dual-core processor, you would think that it would be able to handle it.
When you're in a world where most games are focusing on quad cores, then yeah.
Okay, fair enough.
It just seems odd that you got that you can play one open world game, but you can't play the other one. It might be that Watch Dogs has got more going on in it in terms of an open world sense than Skyrim does.
Well, it's also like I said, even though you're playing Watch Dogs solo, when you get to a certain point, the multiplayer is open. So you technically have the multiplayer and the solo going at the same time.
Yeah.
Whereas Skyrim, it don't matter how far you're in the game, it's still solo.
Yeah, that might be it.
Your computer doesn't even like high-end flash games, but it will play Payday 2?
He's got a point there.
Yeah.
I've seen that too. Computers that don't like Flash but can play any game just perfect.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
I gotta believe that all technology, no matter how good it is, got something a little weird to it. Tech has its hiccups because, well, we're not exactly perfect.
I think some of it's user end, and then some of it's just shit happens.
Yeah.
I mean, point blank.
Great.
I'm assuming you want to see the Arkham Knight footage.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Our first look at Arkham Knight gameplay.
This looks
legit. I figured that wasn't even needed to be asked.
Yep.
I will tell you straight up, this looks legit.
Yeah. As a couple quick
three
notes.
Three times already today, Glock.
Yep.
I'm going to get up to six and then I'm going to stop just like yesterday.
I swear, I need to add a screen region just like in this area right here. And set it up, and every time that you say legit, add another one to it.
Okay. We lost Legend of Steve.
He left a while back.
Although, we're keeping Cliff Jr. He likes us, apparently. Don't understand why. We're a bunch of weirdos.
Speak for yourself, Clock.
I'm speaking for all of us. You can shut up.
But like I was saying, two quick notes. Scarecrow Nightmare Missions will be coming to PlayStation 4 exclusively. And it's
They're
a part of the
new... exclusively?
Well, yeah, it's exclusively.
That's true, Sony.
And this also comes of the... this is also a part of the new Batmobile Battle Mode gameplay trailer, which you can watch below.
Which we are watching below.
Yep.
Let's do this.
Alright, then. Queuing up the trailer, then, in 3, 2, 1, go!
May contain content inappropriate for children. Is that the same voice actor?
Which one? The Origins one or the
City.
Asylum City one?
Asylum and City.
Yes, I believe that is what's his name? Darn, I can't remember. But it's the same guy that was in an animated series. I believe that's him.
Okay.
Kevin Conroy, that's what it is. Don't think it's the other guy they had, which is not only no. Wait, it was Troy Baker. And no, it wasn't Troy Baker.
Haha.
Yeah. Like that seamless transition from on foot to the Batmobile.
I know. It just looks awesome.
And apparently a destructible environment.
Well, you're really getting a lot more natural destructibility with this new generation of consoles, because there's that power to be able to do that.
Thank you, Asylum One, for following us.
Oh, hello.
I think that officially makes 30.
I think it does.
Wait.
I think we're
We've got Asylum One, Cliff Jr.
Wait, nope, 32.
Oh, wow.
Hippopotamus.
Diagnosis.
2, King Austin 28, and Watch Dogs 27.
Weapon systems online.
Be careful.
Thank y'all. Dropping by. Also, Glock, just to let you know, you might want to start digging up images from the Arkham Knight booth.
Why?
I'm not going to tell you why. You just need to start digging them up.
Why?
You're going to enjoy what you're going to see. Trust me.
Like, I'm going to... freak out in amazement and joy, or...
Thank you, KJack04, for following us, too.
Oh, and thank you, other
hello,
person.
Hello, everyone.
Hi, everyone.
I am so glad that we put
We've
in that plug in.
I know.
Oh, hello, Unbaked Fries.
Yeah, he booked it out earlier.
Apparently he didn't like the fact that I timed him out. Which means that was successful.
He is probably hoping for more of a reaction, but... not how I like to deal with trolls.
I don't care. You come in here and talk crap, I'm gonna give you a little warning, and then if you keep on, then... bye.
I will say that I like that new, surprise takedown system. I assume it's a system.
Yeah, it's a system.
It's gonna really make, gameplay really interesting. Lovely,
lovely money. What I want to know, though, is did they do anything more, like, in the booth with Rainbow Six Siege? So that's who we
had. Far as I know, it's playable, but I haven't heard anything new from Siege.
Okay.
Well, that was actually video, wasn't it?
Yeah, that's a part of the video.
Well, my flash crashed, so I didn't know if it was trying to fuck up right there, too.
How many lives will you destroy in pursuit of what you
that's kind of a callback to the original Arkham Asylum, to the original Arkham game.
You are the product of everything you fear. Violence.
Hello, Asylum 1. Thanks, welcome back. Helplessness. I just stepped one.
All that remains is for you to watch as I drag your beloved Gotham into oblivion.
You got to admit, Scarecrow looks cool.
It's an interesting redesign because, well, not really a redesign, kind of a, I want to say a suit upgrade for him because it looks mostly like the same Scarecrow we've gotten in the past Arkham games. It's looked like they've done more work facially for him.
Yeah, he looks good.
Although you still see all the usual stuff. And once again, pre-order now to play as Harley Quinn. Sorry about that.
I wonder if there's going to be any story whatsoever about that.
What, with the Harley Quinn stuff?
Yeah.
I don't think so, because I don't think it's ever really been really story-wise. I think the only one that was story was Arkham City with Catwoman.
Oh, okay.
Asylum can let you play as Joker, but that was only in the challenge maps. Origins lets you play as Deathstroke, but I think, again, it was only in the challenge map stuff.
Yeah, that was only the challenge maps, I think.
So, it might be...
Hi, Steve.
Might be, but since they're not really talking about it, it might not. Although, I don't... Yeah. No, they did. I was thinking for a second, it's like, did they say whether the Catwoman stuff was story beforehand, or did they leave that to be found out about? Oh, by the way, Glock, you're wrong on the Kingdom Hearts 3 footage.
Yeah, I realized that.
That was the 2.5 Birth by Sleep footage.
Yeah, I realized that.
Although 2.5 looks really good.
Yeah, it does.
Alright. We'll end off our little Sony talk with the debut of Uncharted 4: A Thief's End. Well, the proper debut. We got a debut 5 months ago.
Yeah, about that much.
Yeah, about 5 months ago.
Yeah.
For Uncharted 4.
Yeah, where we knew an Uncharted is coming.
Yep.
And thank you, Nuckies, for following us too.
Who? Let me see. Who?
Nuckies.
Yeah.
I don't see that, but okay. I see feared chasms.
Yeah, I was about to say, don't rely too much on the chat list to see who's in and who's here and who list here and who it doesn't list, because have to say, I've gotten intermediate lag spikes with Twitch's chat. Because I can see that with Hex chat, so I'm like,
Twitch chat's it's not being with the IRC grabber. Apparently, because both of them, it's like that. It's like Twitch doesn't know how to do a good IRC chat at all.
Yeah, Cliff, Uncharted 4 looks like it's going to be amazing.
Yeah.
It might have only been a trailer, but oh god, it looks amazing.
I love the little touch from the end that they put in there from the end of Uncharted 3. It's not prominent, but it's there, and I like that. But quick summary that we got up top. Several years after his last adventure, aka 3, retired fortune hunter Nathan Drake is forced back into the world of thieves. With the stakes much more personal, Drake embraces and embarks on a globe-trotting journey in pursuit of a historic conspiracy behind a fabled pirate treasure, which...
Blackbeard!
Not Blackbeard.
Ah, what was it? There's a TV show about him now. There's a game about him.
Yeah. Ah, crap. I know IGN, I watched an IGN Rewind Theater that talked about the original teaser for Uncharted 4 and what they got from the hints, and it sounds like it's this, but I don't remember the specifics. But it sounds like it. It's this fabled pirate island that's like a treasure trove for pirates. It's kind of like
a pirate's paradise.
Yeah, kind of like Port Tortuga from the Pirates of the Caribbean series.
Yeah.
That idea. But it's this island that it was essentially a pirate country.
So it's like the that island on 4 Black Flags. The main island.
You're going to have to give me a name. Remember, haven't played 4 yet.
I can't remember the name of the island. It's been a while since I played 4. But, no Blackbeard? Never mind, I lost interest. But,
yeah, essentially it's that.
Yeah.
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 I forget what that island is called, though. It was on Black Flags. And it was your main island because it was basically your base of operations in the game.
Yeah. That's essentially what it is, and I believe there's supposed to be a fast fortune on there. Granted, this is all story. It's all fictional. I believe there's no real evidence of this so-called island, because I think it was off the coast of Italy? Not Italy. India, I think? I think that's where it's supposed to be, where it was.
I think we already went through the Warcraft 4 trailer, YOLO. Sorry. Yeah.
You'd be able to check the archive to watch it.
Yeah. The archive, or you can go to our YouTube. This will probably be uploaded to YouTube.
It will be posted on the site tgstgsr.org tomorrow, along with yesterday's coverage.
Yeah, I'll do that.
We apologize for the inconvenience.
Yeah. I kind of wound up behind, or I would have had yesterday's up today.
Alright, I'll be back.
Nope. Crap.
Nanny, where is your cane?
He walked away, so...
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah.
Bravo,
the end of the... Yeah. They end this conference with a sizzle reel, which I don't think had anything that we haven't watched or wasn't at the press conference to some capacity. Except 2.5 HDs in there. Oh, Dragon Age Inquisition's in there. Skimming through. Yeah, it looks to be just about everything that was at the press conference, really. But yeah, Sony had a freaking jam-packed conference in about 2 hours, estimate-wise. Right, the only one that has watched it in its full capacity is the one that just walked away. Thank you, Glock.
Which he didn't technically get to watch. Well, he got to watch, but not hear all of it.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Yeah.
All right, time to get back.
All right.
Where are we at?
Hi,
Spencer. Friend. What's up?
So about to queue up the Uncharted 4 trailer, wait until you got back, since you walked away before I could start the count.
Sorry, my grandmother needs help. She messed up her foot a while back, so...
Like, bad, or?
Well, she didn't mess it up. She had a calcium deposit in her heel right there beside her Achilles tendon. They had to do surgery to take it out, and they had to be extremely careful not to damage the Achilles tendon. So now she can't walk for, like, a couple weeks without, like, a cane or any type of support.
Okay.
But she's too stubborn to understand that and tries to walk by herself.
Thank you, Spencer, for following the channel. As far as your question there, honestly, we were telling Yolo back a little bit ago that really that kind of depends on what game style you're looking for.
Those will be out for PS4. They're out now yet.
Wait, what?
It's Spencer who's asking if, you...
No, I'm talking about Cliff. You don't... What? They all are...
God, I hate Twitch's lag. But,
Far Guy 4's trailer should be in the Twitch archive soon-ish. We didn't watch the Disney trailer, although, honestly, you'll probably have a better judge of the game if you take a look at last year's E3 footage, because that's actual gameplay.
Yeah.
It'd be a better comparison, because the gameplay trailer
they didn't have much gameplay at all this year.
Yeah, it's coming out.
It was mostly almost like a view, like a spectator's perspective of them playing, and it was really just like a video trailer type thing.
All right, let's get the Uncharted 4 trailer out of the way.
No, they aren't out on PS4 yet. They will be, but they're not yet.
All right, then queuing up then in 3, 2, 1, go.
Only on PlayStation. Why do you only have to be on PlayStation? Why?
Because it's Naughty Dog.
But Naughty Dog can work with Xbox for once.
No.
Let us have the experience.
No.
Why?
Naughty Dog does good on Sony.
Yeah. I mean, they could multi-platform like Insomniac, but they haven't done it yet.
So, what do you think?
It's a lot to take in, kid. Where do I even start? You've been out of the game for a long time. Now maybe I need to remind you the kind of people we'd be crossing here.
Sully, I know the risks, but come on, it's a surefire plan.
Yeah. If there's one thing I've learned in all these years, it's there's no such thing as a surefire plan.
Yeah, Nathan, you should realize that by now.
I don't really.
Nothing has gone according to plan in the Uncharted series.
You know that.
Seriously.
Yeah, maybe you're right. I've been out of the game, but I need back in. So can I count on you? One last time.
All right, kid. Let's go do it. One last time.
What I'm getting from this is Sully is now missing. At least I hope he's missing.
Oh boy, that trailer hits so bad and he's gonna die.
Well, that was kind of a thing they already did in 3 and in 1. Did they do it in 2? I don't think they did it in 2. I don't think they did it in 2. But they...
Honestly, I think the Xbox One has potential, it's just that it's not being used to its full potential.
Yeah. Yet. And I think if anyone gets it to its full potential, it's going to be Microsoft. I don't think we're going to see another dev do it.
Nah, Insomniac can do it.
They're going I think all the other devs are going to be scared. Because they're going to try to break
scared.
It.
Are you kidding?
Yeah, they really didn't say anything about Uncharted 4. Although, to be honest, that's what they normally do for the first
version. That is normal for this. Did y'all look at Bloodborne? I don't know if we got through Bloodborne in this one.
We already looked at Bloodborne.
Aww,
the second spiritual sequel to Demon's Souls.
I wanted to be here to see. Oh! What did y'all think of No Man's Sky?
We already looked at that, remember?
I know. What did y'all think of it?
But we didn't look at the trailer.
Y'all didn't look at the trailer?
Not this time, because we'd already done it on the show before.
Yeah.
When? It wasn't on Xbox.
No, this was back during the VGAs. Remember, that's when it debuted.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
I forget. I'm sorry.
So amazing that only five people were working on that game.
There's not that many. I think
it's a small number.
Yeah, it was a very small number, but oh dear God, that game looks amazing. Yeah. By Hello Games, there's only like 5 or 6 people.
Yeah. All right then. Sony, much like Microsoft, was trying to go wall to wall with all the gaming stuff. Talked about the PlayStation 4 a little bit, but not much, so it might edge out Microsoft. I still have to sit down and watch the conference to give it a fair shake.
I kind of find it funny, though. Sony legitimately tried to beat Microsoft out by sheer amount of time.
Yeah.
They did. They tried. Did you hear that IGN said that Microsoft won the conference?
Why?
They said that Microsoft just had better content, apparently. They loved it for some reason. IGN said that Microsoft won the conference war this year.
I wouldn't say they had better content. I think Sony and Microsoft had about the same content. You can see Microsoft had games that were coming out soon. They only hinted at some games. Sony did the same thing. The thing Sony did differently was they at least talked about internal systems for the PlayStation 4, talking about the PSTV, PlayStation Now.
That
might be why. Microsoft came out swinging with, hey, guess what? This year it's games, and more games. Wait, why was Cliff Jr.'s...
Yeah, why?
I don't know why.
Why Nightbot? Why?
Why
Nightbot? Nightbot, I think you're giving the wrong warning to someone for spamming.
Nightbot, stop it. Yeah. Stop it.
I will unmod you, Nightbot.
Bad Nightbot.
What the fuck was that, Nightbot? Really?
Yeah.
Seriously, come on. Get your crap together. Jesus.
Yeah, but like I said, Spinner, if you want to... I'm not going to play the Deadline 2 trailer because we already looked at it. Yeah. Alright. Can we move on to the Sony event then?
That was the Sony.
Yeah, we're on Nintendo now.
Not the Sony, the Nintendo event. Ignore me, I'm dumb. Yeah.
Are we gonna watch the whole digital event?
No. Why would we watch the whole digital event? Well, we've not watched the whole event for anybody else.
Why not? Because theirs is only like 45 minutes. Everyone else is 1 hour to 2 hours.
Yeah. Yeah, sorry about that, Cliff. And as I said, Spencer, we've already watched the Deadline trailer. We're not going to watch it again.
Yeah, sorry about that, Spencer. Go to our YouTube channel or to our site and you can find it there.
digital event was really only 48 minutes, although Nintendo's been doing stuff since 12 o'clock this afternoon. Like, all day. They've had that. They've had a Nintendo Minute where they recap stuff. They've had the Treehouse where they've demoed stuff that didn't get the demo. They didn't demo for the digital event, plus the Smash Invitational. So they've been going since 12 o'clock this afternoon.
Not games made by EA. The only one that looked good was NHL 15. I have to disagree with you there, Cliff. Honestly, Hardline looked the most impressive out of all of them. Hardline and Mirror's Edge. Those two looked the most impressive out of all of them.
Don't feel bad, Cliff. I get differently, speaking languages ads sometimes.
Really? They're a random
thing. I get it. It's a random kind of thing, but sometimes I'll get it.
I don't.
But anyway, talking about what Nintendo decided to show off for their digital event specifically.
By the way, I'm trying to disable Nightbot for the time being.
Yeah.
So that it don't try to do something stupid while we're doing this.
Yes.
We fix Nightbot later.
Because yeah. I don't know what the hell that was all about. Nightbot just went off the deep end right there.
Wait, why does the name say two more open the doors? I get it.
Anyway, first off, Nintendo decided to give a new name to their NFC figure line, which they call Amiibo.
Amiibo? Amiibo?
Yes.
That is really close to Amiibo.
I know.
Like, really close to Amiibo.
And Smash Brothers will be the first one to support it. And I did not realize that this article covered the same thing that the next one was. I didn't think it said that.
Wait, what? Wii U Mario Maker?
Yes, get to that in a second. Hang on. Hang on.
Get up, Mark.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Oh
my god!
Glock, go back to the top. Go back to the top.
Scroll up.
Do a barrel roll.
God
and
damn it.
Anyway.
Why did I know that was coming out of his mouth?
Smash Bros. Will be the first one to be Amiibo.
You said Amiibo.
Amiibo system, where essentially... You kind of call in your own personal assist trophy. Any of the amiibos and characters can be brought in as, like I said, essentially as an assist trophy that actually levels up and you can customize the moves of. It's essentially what it is.
Huh.
And actually, next article has a picture of all the ones that are coming out. Or that are planned at the moment. I don't know how many are going to be at launch.
The next article you got listed?
Yes.
Oh.
We got Donkey Kong, Link, Fox, Peach, Pit, Wii Fit Trainer, female one, Kirby, male villager, Samus, Mario, Zelda, Pikachu, Yoshi, and Marth are all the ones that are currently on display on the showroom floor. On top of that, there are also planned integrations into the currently released Mario Kart 8, the upcoming Captain Toad Treasure Tracker, which we'll get to in a second, the not talked about at the event, but when I saw the first trailer for it, it looks like 9. Mario Kart 10, and the, something else we'll get to in a second, Yoshi's Woolly World will all be supporting the system. Whether or not they support these specific trophies, I don't know. They didn't really talk about that.
Well, if you remember there, what we covered a while back, their concept with this was to allow the trophies to go amongst multiple games.
Yeah, I know that, but it's like, okay, what will the Wii Fit Trainer figure do in Mario Kart 8 when she's not in the game. See what I mean?
Yeah.
Because everyone I just said is on the roster for Smash Brothers, so it makes sense. It's like, okay, you're bringing in essentially a version of that character that you can customize and essentially be a personal assist trophy for you.
Yes, yes, Zelda.
But how does this work in Mario Kart 8 when half these characters aren't on the roster? Or in Mario Party 10, where again, half these characters won't be on the roster? Or in Captain Toad's Treasure Tracker, where...
That is possibly my microphone that's
possibly. That
I don't have headphones right now. At the moment, I'm sorry.
Or Captain Toad's Treasure Tracker, which looks to be a spinoff of Super Mario World 3. I think it... No, wait, no, that's not the right word for it. The recent Super Mario game that came out on the Wii U... Well, the 3D Mario game that came out on the Wii U, when none of the characters on this Raw, none of the characters I just said are going to be involved in it. See what I mean?
Yeah.
Fixed it!
Yeah, it just is like, wait a minute, something doesn't make sense here. And they didn't really go into that as far as I know. And they'll also release a peripheral so that these will work with the 3DS, so... These will work with the 3DS version of Smash Brothers when it comes out this October, I believe, is when the 3DS version is coming out.
The Amiibos are coming out October what? Yes, I intentionally called them the Amiibos. Yeah.
Oh, and they go right onto the Wii Pad game controller. Actually, on the left side, right where that little square is on there, that's where you put them.
And there will be a additional pad for the 3DS.
Yes. That's the peripheral they're going to come out for them to work with the 3DS. Eventually, it looks like a white hockey puck.
Pretty much.
That's what it is.
Yeah. Don't think the next article covered anything, because everything I just said is covered. Although the trophies look fantastic. I'm going to call them trophies because they look like the Smash Brothers trophies.
Yeah,
they even have what looks like the gold, the symbol that they stand on.
We're taking too long on this.
Fact. Anyway. Next up, Shigeru Miyamoto, for the end of the show, I don't know why this is up front, talked about three projects that he's working on. One of them, he confirmed, is a Wii U Star Fox game that will focus on gamepad usage.
Do a barrel roll!
Not a damn thing was shown about it, and we'll probably not see anything until E3 next year. They just said next year in general, but, that's, what they were saying. The other two projects, I assume, are Project Giant Robot, where you use the Wii controller to control a giant robot to fight other giant robots, and it looks like you're controlling a junk robot, a drunk robot, not a junk robot, a drunk robot.
A drunk robot?
Yes. What?
It looks like, as someone in the stream when I was watching this said, drunk sumo fighting is what
drunk
it looks like.
Drunk sumo fighting?
Yes. That was the best way to describe it. Now, I don't even know how to describe it any better besides that. You're essentially just trying to knock them over. And Project Defense, which looked like you switch between various cameras with the gamepad and shoot lasers at robots that are trying to invade your base.
They're calling it Project Guard on here.
I was going to say the article saying Project Guard.
Oh yeah, that's what the name was. I was thinking Project Defense. I think it's Defense Project Guard, or it's probably just Project Guard. But yeah, that's what Miyamoto is working on.
Cool.
The only thing they showed off was drunk sumo fighting in the Defense game.
Hey, did we get a bingo on Nintendo's?
I don't know. I didn't have the bingo card up at the moment, and considering it was an hour long, probably not.
I'll watch it and get the bingo card up and tell you. We almost got a bingo on Sony.
We did?
Almost.
Alright.
There was like one that we were missing.
Next up, the Mario Maker, which was actually leaked Sunday. because someone sent a tweet from the Nintendo booth, and you could see Mario Maker on one of the signs.
Yeah. They showed the whole list of booths that they had set up, and that was on there.
Yep. Essentially, it is a level creator. You create a level in Mario. Essentially.
Someone's gonna create one of those impossible levels.
Too late! But they were demoing it, and yeah, they showed off some ridiculously hard levels.
I'm talking about troll levels. Someone's gonna make it.
And it looks like it's utilizing the old Mario Brothers from the NES.
Yes. And if you go up the trailer, there's also something else in there.
Waiting on y'all.
Yep. I'm waiting on Flash.
Okay. Darn it, Flash. Why are you being why are you not happy with us tonight?
You don't like me.
Flash? Do you have Shockwave Flash or Adobe?
I have whatever Google Chrome uses.
Google Chrome uses everything. It's just you choose whether you want Shockwave or Adobe. I got Shockwave once, and then I never could get rid of it.
And I want Adobe back. Anyway.
Y'all good?
Yep.
Alright, taking a look at the Mario Maker level creator, essentially, in 3, 2, 1, go.
You forgot one of the,
Yeah. And you can actually do that. You can actually stop the level at any point and start it again.
So basically you can cheat your way through other people's courses?
Probably. Now if you look up at the top left corner, you're gonna see something there. Which is this?
Oh.
You can swap between the art styles of the original Mario Brothers and Super Mario Brothers U. And all levels are compatible with this.
Huh.
And there might be more, I don't know. I don't know if anyone asked the question and or answered it. Plus you have this, plus you have that slim mushroom that I don't know what does. I said too late. Somebody's kind of worried. But yeah, it's just essentially a level creator. Don't know if they're going to do more to it, because what you see in that trailer is literally what they demoed. They demoed between the two art styles. They demoed you doing all of this, so... If there's more to the game, they didn't really say anything about it. I don't believe this is a downloadable title. I think is this a downloadable title? Doesn't say. Doesn't say whether it's a downloadable title or not.
I'd say it'd be a full game.
Yeah.
Oh my god!
What now, Glock?
The GameCube controller!
Glock, that was announced like a month ago.
And it's not really a surprise.
What Glock's saying is they're coming out with a Smash Brothers branded Nintendo GameCube controller, along with a GameCube adapter for the Wii U, because the Game controller is best controller.
I love the GameCube controller. I loved it.
Well, you know, it is kind of good to see that they're going to be able to have the adapter, too.
Yeah.
So, even if you still had your old GameCube controller, you could still hook it up to the Wii U.
Yeah. Although I found out in the chat during the Brawl Invitational that apparently the Wavebird has input lag. Like, considerable input lag.
Really?
Which I've never noticed, but granted, this is in the conference, this is while the Brawl Invitational was going on, so considerable input lag in a competitive sense may not mean much to anyone who doesn't play competitive gaming.
Huh.
So this considerable input lag may not notice that. Unless you're a competitive player, and then it's like, it's got like so many seconds, which actually matters in the competitive sense. But if you're just playing the game, you may not notice it. Alright, next up, a new IP coming from Nintendo that actually is kind of interesting. And they really wanted to show that off, because this got like the most screen time and the PlayStation. Why do I keep saying that? Nintendo's Treehouse event. My mic's repeating? Why is my mic repeating? I'll be repeating. Let me.
Mine?
I think mine. Let me double check things real quick.
Whoa.
Whoa, what?
I might have to put up the technical difficulties image.
Why?
Is it not? Or
check your guys' connections to the TeamSpeak server.
49 MS plus or minus 2.4.
No, that's not what I'm meaning.
That's a whole lot of packet loss. What's going on?
The connection quality. What are both of you sitting at?
I don't know. Where do I look?
Same place. 30, probably around 35. It's a little lower than that right now.
Where do I look?
Okay. Server's derping.
Bottom right
again.
Corner.
Connection info. What am I looking for?
Hover over that bottom right corner icon.
Bottom right corner icon.
Yes.
Connection quality 82%, 83%.
Okay, it's just me then.
It's me too.
Okay, why is it not happening for Glock?
I have no idea why it's not happening for him.
Y'all have the potatoes this time.
Ram's wide open on the server. Okay, yep. Technical difficulties. We will be back in just a second. I'm going to keep the stream going, but it's going to be all muted.
Yeah. Hang on. Alright, technical difficulties are over with. Our TeamSpeak server decided to drop complete quality, so that's why I was repeating, apparently. Because I shouldn't be repeating anymore.
Yeah.
And then it decided to shut us out completely.
I noticed it was doing some kind of a weird pixelation with your guys' audio, but I didn't think nothing about the server about being ready to go.
Okay.
I forgot it. About every 2 weeks, I got to make sure I restart the thing. I need to make a reminder. That way, I don't have that in the middle of the show, but...
Yep. All right. Now, a new IP, as I was saying before we had technical difficulties, that Nintendo's bringing out is called Splatoon, a 4v4 competitive multiplayer game, where the objective is not to kill your opponent. It is to paint the world in the color of your team.
What?
Literally. Also, you are part person, part squid.
Part what?
Yes.
Explain?
No, I'm gonna let
that's the reason
explain.
You can shoot ink.
Yeah. No, you have a water gun that shoots paint.
So then that just... never mind.
Fuck
it. Let's go.
Let's do it.
All right, then. Starting up the Splatoon announcement trailer in 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, nobody that making the Gladiator reference?
Hi? What?
I guess.
Oh, man.
Yeah. And you can refill your cartridges faster during the quit.
Yeah.
All they showed off was Turf War. Which the objective is just to paint the map and your color, and whoever's got the most of their color there wins. Doesn't really matter about kills, because it counts to the point percentage. You've also got special weapons that I think you activate from a meter that you accumulate over time. So you'll get like a paint rocket launcher that shoots out this twister of paint, a paint sniper rifle, which you saw in the trailer. Assuming the roller, all I saw was the rocket launcher in action from one of the demos of it. And all they showed off was a turf war, so there might be more game modes.
You know, I kind of have to agree with Cliff there.
Yeah.
As stupid as it sounds, it looks pretty cool.
Yeah.
Whoa. Hey, Jeremy. Do you know if The Legend of Zelda will be in that, like, art style the entire game?
Quit jumping ahead!
Really cool.
Hang on.
Sorry.
I was going to say something else. What else was I going to say? Crap, now I lost my train of thought. Thank you, Glock. Appreciate that.
This is why we cannot give him a list of articles to look at.
Apparently. So it makes our job easier. I was going to say, the map you saw in the trailer is actually on the gamepad, and that is updated as the game, and that is real time. So, if you see other color going in somewhere, that's where somebody is, in the map. So if you see, instance on the main map they were showing, there's these two little upper paths that are kind of sniper spots. If you see the opposing team's color going through that alley, that is somebody going through there.
So it basically gives you their location.
Yes.
That's going to make it interesting.
Yeah. And if you walk in the other team's paint, it doesn't damage you, but it will slow you down. So you have to be careful about walking in the other team's paint.
Interesting. Very yep. interesting.
Yeah, Nintendo was loving this. The Treehouse was like 2/3 this, I swear. Two separate demos of this game. Two. We only got one demo of Hyrule Warriors, and it confirmed multiple playable characters, because you can play as Minda, Zelda, and Hilda, I believe. Someone else who's shown up in Legend of Zelda, but I don't recognize offhand.
Great.
And all three of them play differently. Plus, Link can use different weapons. He's not just sword and shield. You can have him play a level with the Fire Rod, which is a magic staff / giant sword / giant battle axe / cannon. Like, all in one.
Hmm.
Yeah, we got a trailer for The Legend of Zelda Wii U. Now, we're going to take a look at this trailer, and as a note, and this was said after the digital event, this is all in engine.
Before we start, I really want an answer. Is it going to be in that style art? Because that would be a very impressive game if they could
Lock.
Do it in that art style. Lock.
I just said this trailer is all in engine.
All right, let's do it.
What do you think that means?
Let's do it. I want to see.
All right. Get up, Tommy.
Yep.
All right, taking a look at the Legend of Zelda Wii U trailer in 3, 2, 1, go.
Even though I swear Flash is trying to break.
Yeah.
Like that.
Stop.
Thank you. No, I got a small hiccup.
Last year, okay. I said that revisiting the conventions of the Zelda series would be our theme for the new Zelda game for Wii U. However, before I get into that, let me talk about something that I needed
someone
to
made
help
a note
to
that,
realize this
the way,
ambition.
In
fact,
Link is
it's
holding
something
the bow and
that
arrow
we've wanted to do for a long time in the Legend
like
of Zelda series.
Right-handed, although
and so
apparently off previous Legend of Zelda games,
is our focus.
That is normally how he holds the arrow.
In the earlier releases
so
of the Legend of Zelda games,
why does this
players
matter?
Got to explore a wide area, scrolling up, down, left, and right. However, after the game transitioned to 3D and the hardware continued to evolve, it became harder to create that feel of being in a vast world. For example, in Wind Waker, we used various techniques to create a wide world where you could freely explore many isolated islands. But it was very hard to create one large world where everything felt connected. We had to design small, bounded areas with a defined entrance and exit. And putting them all together made it feel like you were playing in a large world. But you still couldn't cut through the boundaries wherever you liked to explore that world. Today, I'd like to talk to everyone about the latest Zelda game for Wii U. But first, please take a look at how the game looks on screen. This is the new world of Zelda. It's quite a vast world, isn't it? You can even reach those mountains in the distance if you walk far enough. We couldn't create such a wide world like this in the past. As far as what you can do with such a vast field to explore, as soon as those boundaries are removed, it means you can enter any area from any direction. So the puzzle solving in this game begins the moment the player starts to think about where they want to go, how they will get there, and what they will do when they arrive. This is a clean break from the conventions of past games in the Zelda series, where you had to follow a set path and play through the scenario in the right order. I believe this departure will create opportunities for new gameplay that have not been experienced in previous Zelda games. As you can see, and as you know from the Zelda series, the world in these games can be quite peaceful. However, it is a Zelda game after all, so strong enemies will certainly appear, even in this setting. Powerful enemies appearing in such a peaceful world is one of the defining features of the Zelda series.
I think that's one convention we can keep, right?
I'm loving it already. Loving it.
No other information was given outside of... Well, actually, no other information was given to begin with.
Wow.
I'm loving it. I am loving it.
Yeah.
I don't know why, but I'm in love with that art style.
Anyway... New Legend of Zelda coming 2015. That seemed to be a trend with Nintendo. A lot of what I saw at the event, a lot of saw during the digital event, was 2015 outside of Smash Brothers. Next up, we got Yoshi's Woolly World.
I'm gonna have to refresh the page. Hold on. It's starting to get really horrible laggy now.
Yeah. Which seems to be a kind of a pseudo sequel to Kirby's Epic Yarn in terms of a style. Which, down below, you'll see that they showed Rainbow Curse, along with a new trailer for Hyrule Warriors, which I believe showed off all the new playable characters. And they've also showed off at the show Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, showing off the Mega Evolutions for the three starters for the Hoenn region, along with the D Evolutions for the two legendaries of Ruby and Sapphire. Sonic Boom wasn't there, and neither was the Monster Hunter, although, both were...
It doesn't have the Zelda theme song, you don't want it?
Probably will have the Zelda theme song eventually.
Probably.
Yeah.
Alright, so we're looking at the Woolly World stuff.
Hold on, I gotta get down there.
Yeah, just let me, back out some of the rest of the stuff. Sonic Boom, we've talked about before. Monster Hunter 4 Ultimate will be the newest installment of the most popular Monster Hunter series. We'll have an expanded moveset and two new moves. Bayonetta 2 for the Wii U is confirmed to have a Nintendo Fine. We won't bother with it then.
Wait, what are we bothering?
I'll get to it in a second.
What?
I noticed. Yeah. Anyway, Bayonetta 2 will be coming with costumes for Bayonetta to transform her into various Nintendo characters, along with the original Bayonetta. New Mario vs. Donkey Kong, Captain Toad's Treasure Tracker, as I talked about before, Mario Party 10, and two Arc Academy titles. Xenoblade Chronicles S, X was also at the digital event, showing off that X tile we saw before. There's Skylanders Trap Team, Just Dance 2015, and two Arc Academy games, along with nothing else besides the Rhythm Final Fantasy game. Anyway, the thing that I was going to link in the article for, but I didn't link it, so I'm not going to link it twice. I'm not going to try to dig it up twice. Was the two new Smash characters that got announced? Apparently, there was not a trailer for them, and I didn't realize it until now. Damn it.
Oops.
It looked like they included everything except the Smash Brothers content. Anyway, the two new characters were announced was Queen Palutena from, or not Queen Palutena, Palutena from the Kid Icarus series will be added to the roster, along with Yor-Mi. Yor-Mi is a playable character in Smash Brothers in one of three fashions. You can either be a melee Mi, a swordsman Mi, or a gunner Mi, with customizable moves for all three.
Huh.
Now, mechanically, that essentially means that the roster at the time, before the two new characters got announced, and I'll get to them in a second, was at 32. That essentially doubled it to 64. Because of the interchangeable moves you have.
Hmm.
Now, I'm guessing at the end of the event, the two new characters that are confirmed, Pac-Man and the return of Mr. Game & Watch. So, essentially, the roster is now at 34, mechanically 68, and aesthetically infinite, because any Mi can be in the game. Any Mi. Even Hitler. You joke about that, but somebody will do it eventually.
Where are we at again?
None of the videos are in there, so we can't show them. And I'm not about to try to dig them up again, since I had to link the wrong article. Yeah. Any Mi can be in the game now. That's the Smash Brothers update.
Great.
Alright. Take a look at Yoshi's Woolly World.
Alright, let me get it up there. Hang on. Sonic Boom. There it is. And okay, ready.
Alright then, taking a look at Yoshi's Woolly World in 3, 2, 1, go.
Why did everyone fall in love with Yoshi?
You. I'll admit, I'm in love with Yoshi too, but why did we all fall in love with him?
Also, that poor Shaggy, his mask got ripped off before he got turned into a ball of yarn.
By the brown ball that came out.
A little bit. A little bit. It's very much. Well, a little bit kind of the fact that it's kind of the same style of how Sackboy's made of. I think they both look to be stuffed yarn thing. Also, yes, the game's cool. Also, you can turn the other Yoshi into an egg. And girl. As that just showed.
Great!
It wouldn't be a Mario co-op, it wouldn't be a Nintendo co-op game if you could not troll your co-op partner to some capacity. Swallow him and spit him out of the enemy. Aw, that's a cute little dog that just killed itself by exploding.
Death by explosion.
Yeah, that.
We all have to. We all have to love Yoshi, dude. We all have to.
Yep. We want to skip over the Wii trailer, or watch that and watch the Hyrule Warriors.
Oh, the Kirby one. Yeah, we can.
Yeah.
Skip over it. I mean, most Kirby games are about the same concept. Yep.
Looks to be a lot more like clay based than a.
Hmm.
Alright, we'll take a look at the new Hyrule Warriors trailer, then we'll move on from Nintendo. There's not much else to talk about.
Alright.
Let's do it.
Alright, take a look at the brand new Hyrule Warriors trailer that shows off the new playable characters in 3, 2, 1, go. Zelda's completely playable. And that's the level they demoed at the treehouse. Which looks like a nasty horror game for sure. Probably mostly because it's made by the people who make time for it.
When he turned to look at her, I was gonna say, well, hi, because they were like right up in his face.
Actually, more Zelda meets Dynasty Warriors, because it's very much a Dynasty Warriors style of game. Yeah. Go around, beat up thousands of enemies, complete objectives while you're at it. Contact the Fairy Lady to pull the moon down from Majora's Mask. Yes, that is a thing. It actually happened. You can look at the treehouse footage to see it. Because, trust me, it's better to see it than to hear about it. Although the guy got a bit cocky on his first time through. And ended up screwing up the demo.
Really?
Yes, he actually failed the demo.
How do you fail a demo?
I don't know.
It's a demo! It's supposed to be easy!
Yeah.
But fun.
But honestly, Hyrule Warriors looks good. And the whole fact that Link can equip multiple weapons, I don't know if Minda can. I didn't notice that Link could equip multiple weapons until the second time he played as Link. And I did not catch the menu when the Minda was being selected as a character, so you might have multiple styles of fighting.
Hmm.
There's around a possibility of 9 playable characters, so you've got 5 more possible characters to play as in this game, so plenty to come.
Are we going to go down?
Let's get past that. One, go to the last two. So, to wrap up our E3 talk for the day, we've got 2 little stories to talk about. One of which is Final Fantasy related. More specifically, Final Fantasy VII.
Oh, so we're not looking at Sonic Boom?
No.
No.
Okay. Are we going to talk about, Xenoblade?
It was a trailer that I'm guessing shows the story, but it didn't show off anything impressive. Might wait for some gameplay to come out.
Aww. Alright, I'll watch it on my own time.
Alright, we're getting Final Fantasy VII G-Bike. What is this? It's a motorcycle chase-based action game.
Wait, where is that? I don't see it.
Yeah, iOS and Android free-to-play.
Next article block.
I don't see it on here.
Next article block.
Oh.
Duh.
Yeah.
Shut up.
Well, it was a Sonic Boom, and I doubt there's anything new that we haven't already seen from Sonic Boom. Don't think.
So is this like a racing game?
I have no idea. I have not looked yet. It's got limits unique to Final Fantasy VII. It offers rich gameplay, including numerous missions and character development. Just like any buzzword back-of-the-box stuff will say.
Try
best action game.
Yeah.
Screw Cloud.
Why?
But Cloud, he's so beast.
Zack was better. Screw Cloud.
Aw, but he's got a big sword.
Screw Cloud. He became a douchebag after Zack died. Screw him.
Aw, but he's got pointy hair.
I don't give a crap. A Zack sword. Had better hair.
Alright, let's take a look at this trailer.
Alright, let's watch it. Let's do it.
Right, starting up then
Cloud.
Alright, starting up then in 3, 2, 1, go.
Zack was so much better than him.
That's his work point. Was expecting rock music. Okay then.
This is an interesting idea.
Yeah. I would not have thought of motorcycle battles.
I think if they do that eventually, I've always thought Cloud was supposed to be associated with a motorcycle. Which they also have that huge chase scene in Advent Children.
Interesting.
Yeah. Yeah. Interesting's a word for it. I don't know what the hell to say about that, but like, yep, that's a motorcycle chase game with involving Cloud from Final Fantasy VII.
Yeah, that's about all that can be said about it.
Yeah.
We really didn't get nothing outside of that.
I was kind of expecting possibly something worse. But that just kind of looks... eh. Know what I mean?
Yeah.
It would have been better with Zack.
I think anything Final Fantasy VII, according to you, would be better with Zack.
Pretty much.
It would. Zack was so much better.
So you would want a Crisis Core prequel?
I want a Crisis Core remake for a console.
You had to open that door. You had to open that door.
People have
I'm sorry. Just make an HD, make an HD version, and bring it to consoles.
This
that
is why I say you had to open
it.
That door.
That game is worthy of it. It deserves it.
But look, like you can think it's on a console because you get PlayStation TV, so you can play Crisis Core on TV on your TV.
But it's not
essentially the same thing.
It's the same thing.
People have been demanding a Final Fantasy VII remake for about like 5 years now, and that ain't happening.
Final Fantasy VII remake. I want Crisis Core remade.
If the whole Final Fantasy community that is pushing for a 7 remake can't even get that, do you really think Crisis Core is going to get a remake?
Yes, because Zack is awesome.
Tell it to everyone else that likes 7.
7 was okay, I'll admit that. I just don't like Cloud.
The whole basis for liking 7 is Cloud.
No, I liked all the other characters, Tifa, etc. But Cloud I didn't like.
But like I was gonna say, it was if everyone demanding a Final Fantasy VII remake for 5 years now is not gonna get a remake, what chance do you think Crisis Core stands? Granted, yep. There are reasons outside of that for a Final Fantasy VII game to not be made, but really, is there a demand for a Crisis Core remake?
Come on. Crisis Core was already in 3D and everything else. They wouldn't have to do much to give an HD remake. Just slap some controls on it for a console and you're good to go.
Maybe.
Put up a couple more resolutions, bam.
Maybe, but is there a demand for it?
I'm demanding it.
Besides you.
Every Crisis Core fan in the world?
And how many is that?
It's a minority, but still.
Exactly.
Maybe we could get the rest of the fans to look at us because they never touched it.
That might be a start. You have to think the big picture, Glock. The big picture.
But anyhow.
Yes.
We need to move on because...
They never touched it though was because it was for PSP.
We are moving on.
To wrap up our E3 talk for today, Itaki's Devil Third, exclusive to Wii U.
What? Hang on.
Something I noticed that
Devil Third.
I have no idea. That's why I picked it up, just to see what the hell this thing was. We got it all queued up and ready?
Yep.
Yeah.
Alright, taking a look at this game.
Wait, hang on.
Apparently this used to be a THQ game.
Wow, okay. Wow, that's taking a while to dig up.
Because it says down there it's being developed by Valhalla Game Studios and was originally marked for PS3, 360, and PC when THQ had it.
So now it's only going to be for Wii U?
Apparently.
Well, great.
I don't remember saying this game when we were talking about the THQ selling, but...
Maybe it was one of those we just kind of hit and went on kind of deal.
Yeah, or it might have been under a different name.
Yeah.
Alright. Starting up the trailer then. 3, 2, 1, go.
May contain content inappropriate for children. We've seen that a lot today, haven't we?
The standard ESRB thing for anything I think above E, really.
Yeah.
Hi, Lucas! Is that a cat?
No, not a cat.
Did he ask if that was a cat?
Yes. Okay.
Ow! Ooh, Jesus! And he was playing the drums.
Die, motherfucker!
Wow!
I'm off the leash.
What the hell?
Ivan!
Jane.
Hello, Ivan. It's been years since you've come to my
Holy crap! Did anyone else see how much freaking weaponry he had on her?
Yeah.
Is this what you've become, Ivan? Are you blind to the suffering?
Just me, or is this, like, look like just something you would see on the shelf and not really know about, like last console generation?
Yeah.
But,
yeah.
Kind of reminds me of, like, a style of thing from Nani.
I kind of can see that correlation there.
Yeah, kinda.
Looks this... like Dante's Inferno meets any horror game meets Mortal Kombat. How is that a horror game?
I don't know, it just seems like... I don't know if schlock's the right word for it, but it kind of feels that way. Like, in terms of, like, a movie, like, a schlock movie. Kind of feels like that. I'm like, okay, yeah, I could see why this was... Now. Looks like something that's been sitting on a development shelf somewhere, developer shelf somewhere, and it's like, we're gonna put this game out on the Wii U because... We need money. And we barely have anything invested in this, so anything we get, we'll make money. So, yeah, that did not look that good. So, yeah. That, all enough for tonight, because it's 12 o'clock, we've been going for 3 hours, and we still got 2 more days to go. Luckily, tomorrow we're not talking about a single press conference. We are talking about any other game under the sun. We'll probably hit some stuff that we've kind of skipped over here. Because there'll be something else to talk about then. Hopefully. But anyway, for Locke and Tommy, I'm Peace. Night, everybody. I'll see you tomorrow.
Night.
As always, you can find the Game and Saloon on our site at tgstgsr.org. Don't forget to follow us on our social medias, on Twitter by following @TGSaloon, on Facebook at facebook.com/thegameandsaloon, and on YouTube at youtube.com/TGSaloon. Till next time.